Hello, my name's Lawrence, and I'm going to take you today through a yoga practice that's going to be part one of a three-part series. This three-part series is for beginners. When we look at the yoga practice, and when we look at the stages of beginning, middle, and end, they really allow us to add meaning to our practice. The beginning of practice is a place to gain foundation. The beginning of practice is a place to gain a sense of understanding for the entire journey that we're going to take. Today's part one. It's the part of creation. It's the part of foundation. Please close your eyes, cross your legs as we begin. Bring your hands onto your knees. Allow for your sit bones to be heavy. If you find that your knees are really high, what you might want to do is just grab a book or if you have a block to sit on. Allow for your shoulders to rest back, soften your jaw and your eyes, and begin to breathe. Fold your hands at the center of your chest. We begin with an offering. An offering is a way to say that our practice is more than just a physical practice. It's also a practice that allows us to move towards an internal awareness. Maybe even have a sense of listening to that inner voice that we all have. From that inner voice arises insight, inspiration. Bow your head. Slowly release your hands, lift your chin. We're gonna have a really nice practice now. I'm gonna start off in a pose called all fours, or cat cow. I come onto my hands and knees. I spread my fingers super wide. This is where we get a sense of foundation, of the ground. Allow for yourself to be heavy. So from the chest, from the hips, everything becomes really grounded. Start to breathe through your nose with an inhale breath, chest forward, hips back. Exhale, round your spine. Inhale, lengthen chest forward. Exhale, round spine. And as you round the spine, separate the shoulder blades. Inhale, chest forward. Exhale, round spine. One more time, full breath in, lengthen. Forward, hips back. And as you exhale, slowly sit onto your heels. You're gonna have your heels together, you're gonna sit on your hips. If this hurts for the knees, you can place a rolled up towel under your knees, or you can also lift your hips up. Interlace your fingers and then push your palms forward. With an inhale breath, please lift your arms all the way up to the sky. The side body is the space between the hips and the armpits. As you take a breath in through your nose, lengthen your side body and lengthen your arms. Exhale, release your arms by your sides. Take your hands behind your back, interweave your fingers, straighten your arms, let the shoulder blades draw in towards each other, lift up your chin. Inhale, breath, fill up the lungs. And exhale, release. Let's do that one more time. Do the opposite interlace, palms forward, soft jaw, inhale, lift your arms up by your ears, and then they can even go behind your ears. Eyes are open, jaw soft, inhale, breath in. Exhale, lengthen. Good. Release your arms, interweave your hands, do that opposite interlace again. So the one that comes naturally, avoid it and come to the strange one. Straighten your arms, lift up your chest, shoulder blades together. Now, fill up through the nose, inhale breath. Exhale breath out. Release. We're gonna come into a pose called child's pose. Arms by your sides, let your head rest, and this is gonna be a nice stretch for your lower back. Allow for your breath to be smooth as you inhale and exhale through your nostrils. Slowly draw your arms forward, spread your fingers, come into all fours. returning to the space that we started. Slowly from here, weight onto the metatarsals. So the metatarsals are the space, the padding just behind your toes. Straighten your legs, downward facing dog. Long arms, long side body, hips super high. Slowly from here, step your feet forward. You're gonna have your feet hip width apart. Make sure that your feet are parallel. And then exhale, release your neck, head hangs, hands interlaced behind your back, straighten, and pull up and away as you allow for your roll, your rib cage, and your head to be super heavy. Let your breath be smooth. Never forget that the breath is the constant of your yoga practice. Breathing in through the nose, breathing out through the nose. Heels are heavy, inside edges of the feet are heavy. Slowly release your hands to your lower back and slowly inhale and rise up to standing. Look forward. Bring your feet together at the top of your mat. Fold your hands at the center of your chest. On an inhale breath, lift your arms all the way up, palms touch. On an exhale, hands at the center of your chest. Breathing in through your nose, lift up. Arms by your sides. Inhale up. Exhale bow. Hands on the ground, step back to downward facing dog. Spread your fingers, hips nice and high, the upside down V shape. And then inhale, coming to high plank. This is the top of a push-up. Slowly from here, move your hips all the way back, downward dog. Slowly from here, release onto your knees again, heels, beginnings, the beginning, foundation. Heavy on the ground, interlace your hands, palms forward. From the foundation, from the ground, arms up. Exhale, release your arms, hands behind your back. As the arms straighten, chest opens up, collarbones widen, take a full breath in. Palms forward, and do this strange interlace. Palms forward, inhale, lift up. Exhale, release your arms behind your back and come into a nice opening of the chest. Shoulder blades draw towards each other, lift up chin, inhale, breath in. Release your hands. Coming to child's pose, returning to where we were already. Maybe it feels different than the first time. Just notice, take a deep inhale breath in. Long breath out. Drag your arms forward, look forward, all fours. We'll do one inhale cat pose. Round the spine, and an exhale cow pose. Chest forward. Downward facing dog on the inhale, straighten your legs. Slowly step your feet forward, hip width apart. Hold your opposite elbows this time. Again, relax your neck. Next, relax inner thighs from the inner knees all the way up through the inner groin. Lifts up, lifts up, lifts up. And then bend your knees. Inhale, rise up to standing. Lift your arms all the way up. Release your arms by your sides. Let's bring our feet together. We're gonna come into a really easy, but really effective side stretch. Hold your hands at the center of your chest. Release your arms, inhale, lift both arms up. Interlace your fingers, and then slowly draw your hips to the left as your arms go to the right. Soft jaw. Breath moves to the left side. Chin lifts up. Belly pulls in. Hips to the left, hips to the left, hips to the left. Inhale, rise up. Release your arms. On an inhale, lift your arms up. Interweave the fingers, maybe even do the strange interweave. Straighten your arms, go to the left side. Arms behind your ears. Breath is smooth, in and out your nose. Every exhale, deepen, 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 deepen. Inhale, rise up to standing. Release your arms by your side. Inhale, lift your arms all the way up. Release just your left arm by your side. Right arm reaches to the left side. Slowly rise up. Both arms up. Right arm releases. Left arm to the right side. You can really feel the extension side body, right at the hips on the left side. Inhale, rise up, both arms lift. Release your arms by your sides. Fold your hands at the center of your chest. Inhale, lift both arms up. As you exhale, bow, bend your knees, hips back, release your hands to the ground. You can bend your knees to make sure that your hands touch the ground. Step back, hold your downward dog for a third time. From the center of your chest, we call that the heart area, push your hands away from you. From the center of your chest, lift your hips up and draw your heels to the ground. Inhale, high plank, top of the push-up. Slowly from here, release onto your knees, sit back. We're gonna do a twist now. So twists can be a little complicated and even like sometimes uncomfortable, but that's normal. The idea of a twist is you really want to get a sense of heaviness in your hips. The heaviness in the hips creates the foundation. And then we lengthen the spine and lift the rib cage up together. Inhale, lift your arms up. Feel that sense of pushing down from the hips all the way through the feet. And then exhale, left hand to the outside of your right knee, right arm back. Take a full breath in, lift up your chest. Exhale and twist. Full breath in. Left side of your body twists to the right side. One more time, full breath in. Exhale, moving from the left all the way to the right. Rotation, rotation, rotation. And then as you untwist, inhale, lift your arms up. So use the breath as like a sense of momentum. Up. Exhale, twist. Let's go to the other side. Right hand, left knee, outer thigh. Left hand on the ground. Full breath in. Lift the ribcage up. Exhale, rotation. Taking the right side to the left side. Lift up chin so that the neck is long. One more time. Full breath in. Exhale, twist, 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 twist. Inhale, rise back up to sit with your arms. Exhale, release your arms by your sides. Child's pose. We're returning back to the shape. Maybe it feels different. Time three, third time. Arms forward, hands on the ground. Spread your fingers, all fours. Tabletop. On an inhale this time, chest forward. On an exhale, round spine. Let's do that two more times. Momentum. Inhale, chest forward. Exhale, round your spine. Let's do it again. Inhale, forward. Exhale, downward facing dog. Lift your hips nice and high. Step your right foot forward between your hands. If it doesn't get there, which is completely normal, you just pick it up, place it there so it's right there between your hands, and then lift up your chest. Inhale, lift your arms up to the sky. And just stay here. It seems pretty simple, right? Like we're literally just lifting up our arms, one knee on the ground. Bend your knee a little bit deeper. And now we're gonna find a little bit of depth. As you bend the knee deeper, keeping your right heel on the ground, draw your arms back, lift up your chest. Jaw soft, eyes soft. Maybe even smile, take a deep breath in. Yeah, beautiful. Release your hands to the ground. Step back, down dog, switch legs. Left foot forward, you know the drill. If you need to, pick up the leg and place it. Inhale, lift your arms up. If we think and feel into foundation right now, we're allowing for ourselves to look forward, lift the chin up, but get a sense of hips towards the ground. Feet heavy, like an anchor. Inhale, lift your arms up. Keeping the left heel on the ground, draw your knee forward and draw your whole body back, arms back. Lift up chin. Soft smile, so even as you're moving into the depth, into the intensity, there's a sense of, yes, this is good, it feels good. And then slowly from here, release your hands, step your right foot forward between your hands. Nicely done. Bow. Inhale, rise up to standing. Release your arms by your sides. We're gonna do a back bend. Have your feet together. Inhale, lift your arms up to the sky. Hook your thumbs. As your thumbs are hooked, bend your elbows. When the elbows are bent, the joints and the shoulders become free and mobile. So we're gonna inhale, lengthen the side body, get super long. And then exhale, elbow, shoulders back. And then take the head back. And then push the hips forward. It's like we're leaning on our shoulder blades. Full breath in. Exhale, chin up, arms back. Shoulder blades carry the weight. Keep your legs strong. Lift up chin. Look up to the sky, to the ceiling. Straighten your elbows for depth. And then slowly come all the way back up. Now from here, you're gonna bend your knees. Feet are together, bend the knees. Bring your rib cage onto your thighs. You wanna keep them like that. Then we're gonna hold our heels. Get your fingers right under your heels. Relax your neck. Knees together. Bend your elbows, squeeze those biceps. You're leaning forward, and as you're leaning forward, you're gonna allow yourself to straighten your legs by pulling on your heels. There's a feeling of arms moving, working, biceps, elbows back, and then slowly from here, bend the knees, inhale and rise up, all the way up. Release your arms by your sides. Nicely done. Coming back to the top of my mat, inhale, lift your right arm up. Take your right arm to the left side. Soft jaw, stay, pull belly in, right hip, right side, right arm, left side, and then inhale, rise up, switch sides, up, left arm, right side. Lift up chin, go all the way, hip all the way, hip all the way to the left, left arm all the way to the right. Nicely done, lift all the way up. Release your arms by your sides. Looking forward, fold your hands at the center of your chest. Inhale, lift your arms up. Exhale, bend your knees for a bow. Hands on the ground, step your left leg back. So now the right foot's between, left leg is back. We're gonna look forward, place one hand and then the other hand onto your hip as you lift up your chest. Bend your knee deep, lift your arms up. Soften into your breath. What does that mean, soften into your breath? It means allow for yourself to get confident. Allow for your foundation to be set and then really focus on your inhale. Exhale. Bend your knee deeper. Inhale. Exhale. Release your hands to the ground. Pause. Left hand is heavy. So left hand is under your left shoulder. On an inhale breath, lift your right arm up to the sky. Bend your right knee just a little bit deeper and twist the left side of your body to the ceiling. Lift up, reach up, and then slowly release. So we're gonna switch legs. Step back with your right foot. Step forward with your left foot. Grounded. Set. Hands on hips. Inhale, lift chest up. Bend your knee just a little bit deeper. Inhale, lift your arms way high. Chest is where the breath is. Jaw is where the softness is. Foundation is where the anchor is. Bend your left knee a little bit deeper. Take your arms back. You're gonna feel the stretch in the front of your back leg. Lift up, look up, rise up, and then release your hands to the ground. Your right hand is below your right shoulder. Inhale, lift your left arm up. Breathing smoothly and consistently. In, X, in, release your hands to the ground. Step back, let's do downward facing dog. Again, let's lower down onto our knees, but this time, tuck your toes. You're gonna literally just hook your toes under your feet and lean back onto your heels. And that's gonna create a really nice stretch in the metatarsals and in the toes, and we don't usually stretch them. We don't do much thinking of the toes. We do more covering up of the toes, right? A neck stretch now. With an inhale breath, lift your right arm up. Right arm is lifted, bend your right elbow, grab onto the left ear, left arm to the left side, and the left arm lowers below your left shoulder. Look forward. You can even close your eyes. We're gonna take three breaths here. On every exhale, heavy head, long left arm. Heavy head, long left arm. Heavy head, long left arm. And then without engaging the neck, you're gonna take your right hand to the cheek and then lift up. Yeah, it's a little bit of taking care of yourself. Inhale, lift up your left arm. Bend your left elbow. Draw your head towards the right side, extend your arm towards the right side. You can close your eyes like I did. Soften your jaw and your tongue. Extending your right arm real long, lower than the shoulder. The scalene muscles are the muscles that we're stretching here. They're the side neck muscles. Take a deep in. Long breath out. Really good. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Slowly from here, left hand lifts up your head. Release your toes. This is one of those moments where you just go, huh. Gonna come back into all fours. We return. Exhale, cat pose. Inhale, cow, chest forward, inner thighs roll back. Exhale, cat pose, round, 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 round spine. Good, come back to center, and we're gonna do something that we don't normally do. We're gonna go to the right, up, to the left, and down, and then we're gonna create a smooth move. Keep breathing. Feel free to have mobile hips, mobilizing our rib cage. And then we're gonna go the other way. We're gonna go to the right, lower, left, up. Right, lower, left, up. Right, lower, left, up. And then downward facing dog. Come back into that upside down view. Slowly step your right foot forward between your hands. Slowly lower your back knee. Inhale, lift up. We're gonna look forward, get grounded here. Right hand onto your right thigh. Inhale, lift your left arm to the sky. Slowly hook your right elbow to the outside, or excuse me, your left elbow to the outside of your right thigh. Bring your hands together. Look forward and down. Take a deep breath into the left lung. And then exhale, rotate the left side of your body to the right. Full breath in. Exhale, pull belly in and twist. One more time. Twist. And then slowly inhale, lift your arms up. Bring your hands to the ground in front of you. We're gonna step the left foot forward. Feet are at the front of your mat. And then you're gonna come into a pull. And inhale, rise up together. Exhale, hold your hands at the center of your chest. Inhale, lift your arms up. Nice full stretch here. Exhale, bow. Full pull. Hands on the ground. Step your right leg back. Lower your right knee to the ground. Inhale, lift up your chest. Left hand onto your thigh. Inhale, lift your right arm up to the sky. Coming into a twist by hooking the right elbow to the outside. You don't have to go too deep. You just want to get that hook in so there's space for your belly. Left hand and right hand together. Look forward, ground through your right foot. Inhale, breath. Exhale, twist. Look forward, inhale, breath. Exhale, twist. Inhale, breath. Exhale, twist. And then slowly from here, unwind. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, release your hands. Step your right foot forward between your hands. Bow. Inhale, rise up to standing. We're gonna bring that all together now. Hold your hands at the center of your chest. Bring your hands together. Inhale, lift your arms up. Exhale, bend your knees as you bow. Hands on the ground, step back, we'll do down dog. Inhale into high plank, top of the push-up. Looking forward, and this is really, like, you can either come down on your knees or keep your legs straight, but this is really where you want to get a sense of trajectory. You want to have your chest move forward as your elbows soften back. And come onto your belly. Toes back, shoulders back. And when I say shoulders back, you can also think of it as collarbones broaden, because the collarbones start at the center of your chest and then they broaden towards the shoulders. Place the hands heavy under your shoulders and then slowly start pushing, but not fully. Keep the arms working, shoulder blades together, shoulders back, and lift up your chin. Lift up your chest. lift up your belly button without lifting up your hips. Lift up your belly without lifting up your hips. Hips heavy, long legs. Slowly lower. Bend your knees. Sit back. Return. 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 Okay. Take a moment, hands on thighs. Close your eyes. Inhale, lift your arms up. Bring your right arm under your left arm. This is called eagle arms. If that's not available to you, you can also just go like that. Lift your elbows just a little bit higher. Take a deep breath in. Long breath out. Good. Slowly from here, lift your arms up. This time, left elbow under right elbow. Full breath in, long breath out. Gonna add some action in our foundation. Inhale, lift your arms up. Exhale, right arm under left. And keeping the theme of right leg first or right arm first, slowly step your right leg forward. Good. Slowly from here, straighten your back knee. Keep your breath moving, feel that added sense of grounding, awareness, and slowly lower your back knee. Inhale, lift your arms up. Release your hands to the ground. This one's called half splits or half Hanumanasana. Straighten your leg, widen your arms. Take a full breath in. Exhale, bend your elbows and bow. You go as deep as your body lets you, but really what you want to focus on is that engaged right leg. Full breath in. Exhale, bend your elbows, bow, 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 and bow just a little bit more. One more time, take a deep breath, and even lift your chin, chest forward, and exhale, bow, bow, bow a little bit more, and then slowly bend your right knee. Release your hands, step your right leg back, sit back. Inhale, lift your arms to the sky. If we're moving fast, take your time. Left arm under right. Do what you can, but do what you can. Slowly from here, step your left foot forward. Breathing deep. Slowly from here, as the weight draws forward, straighten your right leg. Breathing deep, anchoring down. Lift up from the belly button, lift up the elbows. Amazing. Slowly lower. Slowly lift your arms up. Release your arms to the ground. Now, you're going to slowly just step your right knee back. You're going to straighten your left leg. Full breath in. And then exhale. Bend, 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 bend your elbows. The bending of the elbows draws the hips back, lets the chest move forward. Every exhale, as you engage the left leg, maybe you can bend the elbows deeper. Good. Slowly bend the knee, and slowly from here, step the left knee back. Sit down. Being close to the ground is such an advantage in yoga because there's a sense of safety. There's a sense that we all have of being close to the ground, which means that we can be a little bit more relaxed and calm. I'm going to take you into a pose called Ushtrasana, which means camel pose. Inhale and stand on your knees. Take your hands into fists. Place your fists onto your sacrum. The first thing you're going to do is from the center of your collarbone, you're going to draw the shoulders back. So this action here creates a broadening, and then you're going to push the hips forward. Push the hips forward. Push the hips forward and lift the chin up. Push the hips forward and lift the chin up. Push the hips forward, lift the chin up. Lean back, lean back, lean. Good, and then slowly rise up. Just carefully pull your belly in and slowly sit. Nice work. Hands on your thighs, close your eyes. Take a couple of moments of just restoration. As you restore, make sure that your attention is on that which is most important in our yoga practice, and that's our breath. You may slowly open up your eyes and then carefully lift up. We're going to do another variation of this pose called camel. What we're going to do in this variation of camel is, if you're getting the sense of feeling like, okay, I want to go deeper, you could actually take your hands and hold onto your heels. Or, like we did the first time, leave your hands on your sacrum. The sacrum is the bone right at the center of your hips, right above where like the bum begins. So take the fists, place them right there, shoulders back, head back. Ribcage flows back, hips flow forward, head flows back, shoulders draw back. But here, feel the shoulder blades lift your chest up, 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 up. And then if you want to go deeper, right hand, left hand, head back. Full breath in, lift your chest up, up, up. And then slowly return, release. Feet are together, legs are together. Close your eyes. The opening up and stretching the front of your chest can be quite intense, actually. A lot of sensation comes along with stretching the muscles that protect your ribs, protect your heart, protect your lungs. Looking forward or closing your eyes, up to you. Good. From here, slowly bring your hands forward, downward facing dog. Slowly from here, walk your feet forward. Come into a forward fold. Inhale, rise up to standing. Release your arms by your sides. Slowly from here, we're gonna come to the center of our mat. We're gonna do a series of standing poses. One of my favorite transitions into standing poses is what I'm gonna show you now. It's called a jump open. My feet are together. I'll bring my fingers together, I'll bend my knees, and then I'll shoot my arms out and my legs wide. And then when we come back, we go fingers together, bend the knees, and arms by the sides. If that's too challenging for you, you can always just step out. Once again, fingers together, look forward, take a deep breath in, and slowly from here. Amazing. Right foot opens up, arms long, bend your right knee nice and deep. This pose is called Virabhadrasana 2, Warrior 2. You're gonna bend your knee nice and deep. You're gonna take your rib cage back so it's over your pelvis and look forward. Find one spot. Soft jaw, breathe deep. Squeeze your left leg real strong. Bend the knee just a little bit deeper, back leg just a little bit stronger. Another breath in. Slowly straighten. You can bring your hands onto your hips as we transition feet. Right foot forward. Feet are parallel, left foot open, arms open wide. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, bend the knee, bend the knee, bend the knee, bend the knee. Draw the ribcage back, arms open. Take a deep breath in. Bend your left knee deeper. Breath is broad, back leg is strong, arms are soft. Bend the knee, bend the knee, bend the knee, bend the knee, bend the knee. Full breath in. Soft jaw, looking forward, bend the knee, bend the knee, bend the knee. Back leg solid, and then slowly straighten. Hands onto hips, feet parallel, fingers together. Bend the knees, and then inhale, jump. Nice. Okay, we're gonna come into a pose called Trikonasana, triangle pose. Similar to the previous pose, but different. Fingers, take a deep breath in, jump open. Right foot opens up. Slowly from here, we're gonna take the crease of the hips back, crease of the hips back. And as we do, draw the right hand either onto our ankle, onto the floor. Sometimes I have blocks or a book will work if you're at home. And then inhale, lift your left leg, arm up, left arm up. Pull your belly in. Squeeze your right buttock cheek so that it engages and pushes through the right foot to the ground. Look up, lengthen. Awesome. Left hand onto your hips. Bend your knee, rise up. hands on hips, parallel feet, and then open up left foot. Both arms open. Slowly from here, come into triangle pose, Trikonasana on the left side. Left hand on ankle or left hand on ground, but if it's on the ground, it's right below the shoulder. Lift up. Squeeze the muscles of the left leg. Draw the outer rib cage in and draw the lower belly up. Nice. Squeeze the left buttock cheek a little bit more. Breathe in. And slowly from here, bend the knee. And as we bend the knee, we can push into the ground. Lift up. Parallel your feet, fingers together. Bend the knees, legs together. Okay, the next pose is a balancing pose. Bring your feet together. This is gonna be a little bit more challenging for those of you that are new. You're gonna jump open, hands on hips, open up right foot, and then just this transition could be tricky. So as you bend the right knee, you're gonna lift up the left heel. So you're gonna close the hips to the right side of your room or of the mat. From here, lift your arms up, you can interlace the hands, bend the right knee, rest the belly on the thigh, and then slowly straighten the leg. It's a warrior three. It's a balancing pose. Look forward, squeeze both legs, both arms, straight, bend the right knee, step back. Nicely done. Hands come onto your hips, close the right foot, open up the left foot, lift up your back heel, close the hips, lift your arms up. Lengthen, bend, lower, straighten. Or move towards straight. Straighten really refers to we're moving towards straight. Shoulders behind your ears, pull belly in. Good, and then slowly from here, step back, arms up, arms on your hips, parallel your feet. Nice, now since we're here and the feet are already wide, we might as well do a pose called Prasarita, wide-legged forward fold. From the bikini line, I like to call it, or just the hip socket, you're gonna start moving back. And as you move back, bring your hands onto the ground. And then you can bring your fingers so they line up, the tips of your fingers with the tips of your toes. And as you inhale, lengthen the spine, kind of like a cobra pose, or just lengthen the spine long. And as you exhale, bend your elbows, bow. 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 From here, we'll add a twist. Place your right hand right under your head. Inhale, lift your left arm. Reach up. Take your right hip back in space. And just stay here and breathe as you're rotating the right side of your rib cage on your exhale. To the left and up. Nicely done. Slowly release your right hand. Inhale, lift up your left arm. Left arm high, lengthening from the left side of your body up. Or twisting, I should say, as opposed to lengthening. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Lengthen, lengthen. Twist, twist. We're doing both at the same time. Spine long, twisting through the length. And then slowly release. Nicely done. Bend your knees. Inhale, rise up. Bring your fingers together, elbows high, bend your knees, bounce. Now, bring your hands onto your hips. Bend your knees and just do like a small hop. Feet hip-width apart. Open up your feet. And as you open up your feet, the hips are gonna lower. This pose is called Malasana. Breathing deep. Now, squeeze your knees into your elbows, and at the same time, push your elbows out into your knees. Lift up your chin and your chest. Shoulders lower, chest is expansive, so you can fill in this chest and the lungs with a big inhale breath. Nicely done. Slowly from here, release the hands to the ground. Parallel your feet. Rise up. Bring your feet together. Feet together, coming into a pose called tree pose. Bend your right knee. Right foot comes into the inside edge of your left thigh and fold your hands at the center of your chest. The foundation of this pose is everything. Feeling that connection between your hips and your standing leg. Inhale, lift your arms up. Initially, it's the general form of the pose, and then we get the full expression from your side body. Lengthen, look up, stretch. Release your arms by your sides. Maintaining balance, release your foot to the ground. Switching sides, left leg. Bend your left knee. Place your left foot to the inside of the right thigh. Fold your hands at the center of your chest. You'll notice that depending on which side, the pose has its own personality. Shoulders back, breath full. A sense of calm, right? Just a sense of calm. Even as you feel the fragility of that which is balancing. Inhale, lift your arms up. Stretch. General form of the foot pose becomes full expression of the pose. Pull belly and lengthen up, lengthen up, lengthen up. And then slowly from here, come lower. Sometimes when you lengthen, you start to become fragile or more vulnerable. Let's come into a vinyasa. Vinyasa means a dynamic progression or sequence of poses that are connected within each other. Arms by your sides. Inhale, lift your arms up. Exhale, bow. Hands on the ground, step back down. Palms on the ground, inhale into high plank. Exhale, lower onto your belly, bending your elbows. Take your hands behind your back. This one's gonna be called lotus pose, or excuse me, locust pose, or shalabhasana. You're gonna straighten your arms, and then you're gonna lift up your ribs and your chest. Ribs and chest. Arms long, legs long, toes back, and then don't even change this pose. Hands come under your shoulders. Inhale into a cobra pose. Hips stay on the ground, lift your chest up. The chest lifts up from the shoulder blade, so just think back of the body pushes the front of the body forward, and then slowly release. Bend your knees, sit back onto your heels. Inhale, lift your arms up. Right hand, or raw arm, excuse me, over under left. Inhale, lift your arms up. Left arm under right. Inhale, lift your arms up. Right arm under left, right elbow under left. We interweave, palms together. Step your right foot forward. Slowly straighten your back leg. Stay grounded, really become confident. That's what you want to find, confidence in your foundation. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, left elbow twists to the outside of the right leg. Look forward, take a deep breath in. Exhale, twist. Full breath in. Exhale, twist. Full breath in. Exhale, twist. Inhale, release your arms to the ground. Step back to down dog, and we'll move through a plank, a lower, right down to your belly, toes back, cobra pose. Downward facing dog. Full stretch here, which means from your chest, extend your arms. From your chest, lift your hips up and lower your heels. Release your knees to the ground. Look forward. Inhale, lift your arms up to the sky. Left elbow under right. Left leg forward. Right knee slowly lowers up. So if we're moving too fast, take your time. Inhale, lift your arms up. Right elbow hooks to the outside of the left thigh. Allow for yourself to really enjoy the challenge. It is a challenge, right? Full breath in. Twist. 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 Good. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, lower. Step back. Lower down onto your knees. Cross your legs. sit back. We're gonna finish up the practice with a series of forward folds. Those are really nice because they tend to allow for us to not only cool down, but also get more internal. And when we're in a space of internal, what that allows is for us to get a little bit more reflective and insightful. See if it works for you. Fold your right foot into the inner left thigh like a tree pose, kind of like that standing tree that we did earlier. Extend the left leg so it's active. And then slowly walk both arms to either side of your left foot. Take a deep breath in, chest rises up. And then exhale, slowly walk forward. It's on the exhale we're doing that walking forward. Keep that in mind. Again, inhale, fill up. Exhale, slowly walk forward. If you can get your hands to your foot, that might be nice. It might be intense, so you might want to be careful and just hold your ankle or just keep your hands on the ground. Go a little bit deeper, just a little bit deeper, just a little bit deeper, and then slowly walk your hands back, hands by your hips, and you're just going to do, I like this, it's kind of fun, you just do a switch of the legs. You lean back and you go, whoosh. I can show that to you guys again, just lean back and go, whoosh. Not much of a party trick, but keeps me occupied. Ribs move towards the right leg. And slowly from here, you can start moving forward. One thing that I like to do is just create a boundary for my leg. So sometimes my hand right at the side will create that boundary. And grab your foot, breathe deep, breathe super deep. A little bit deeper. Nicely done. And then slowly sit up. Cross both legs. We're going to return to that sense of calm. Hands on your knees. Close your eyes. Shoulders up. When we're in our yoga practice, what becomes available is the present moment. By moving and taking action, by breathing and feeling, we become grounded in the now. And it sounds esoteric, but there's something very true to the way that it pierces through our normal thinking patterns. Done. Lift up your chin, slowly from here, knees together, legs forward. If in any of these poses you're feeling that you're getting a sense of like a rounded back, especially at the beginning, if you're already rounded, in the forward fold it will round, and I'll show you that in a moment. But if you're already kind of sitting like this, you want to lift your hips up. So once again, a brick or a book or something like that, or even a pillow, like will really a blanket will give you a chance to lengthen and free up your lower back, the lumbar spine, which a lot of us have pain in, right? So this is how you free it. The inner thighs draw down. And then from the belly, there's like a sense of lengthening. And as you lengthen it forward, catch your feet or your ankles. A little dramatic the way I grabbed it. Look forward and then just bend your elbows. Ooh, yeah. Focus breath, bend your elbows. And then you can even make that ooh yeah sound. I like to do that sometimes. One more time, full breath in. And then exhale, ooh yeah, your way into a forward fold. Good, slowly rise up. Hands behind your back, and here's another one of those moments. Feet together, you can come really close. We're gonna do a version of, this pose is called Baddha Konasana, which just means bound angle. You're gonna interweave your fingers. Hold on here. And then as you bend your elbows, hopefully it's available to you, you can bend your elbows and just hook them in front of your shins. Then you'll take a nice deep breath in. And as you exhale, your groin and your belly move in opposite directions. Your inner thighs hollow out your groin as your belly button and your chest extend forward. Just breathe. Focus on your breath and allow for your breath to be that much moving. brings you into the depth of the pose. Just breathe. Nicely done. Slowly sit up. Slowly extend your legs forward. Slowly cross your legs. The next pose is called Ardha Matsyendrasana. It's a fancy Sanskrit word for twist. I'll give you two variations, okay? First variation is you'll have your left knee bent, and you'll take your right foot to the outside of your left knee and towards the front of it. Then from here, you can take your right hand behind your back, but you want to not sit on your right heel. You literally want to have your sit bone on the ground. Left arm hooks, look forward. This is variation really two. It's the more advanced one. If this is causing you problems, you can do this variation where your leg is straight. Regardless of your variation, take a deep breath in. Rib cage lengthens away from your lower back. It lifts up. And then exhale, twist. And when you're twisting, focus on the left side, moving towards the right side on your exhale. So first we inhale, exhale, and twist. First we inhale, and then exhale, and we rotate. Inhale, and exhale, and we rotate. And then slowly come back to center. Nice. Hopefully you didn't have too much deep before class. That would be problematic. It would be hard to breathe and hard to move and really uncomfortable. Other side. I'll do the second variation now so you can see what it looks like. But once again, feel free to straighten your, in this case, right leg so that you can have that modified version. Regardless of the variation, you're gonna take your left arm behind your back. You're gonna inhale, lift your right arm up. That right arm lift, like I'm doing now, is an extension of the side body. So you get really long, and then you hook, you can hold onto your knee, you can just bend your elbow, and rotate on exhale. Full breath in. Exhale, twist, 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 twist. Full breath in. Exhale, twist, 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 and twist. One more time, full breath in. And rotation, rotation, rotation. Good, well done. Slowly unwind, slowly cross your legs. I wanna introduce you to something called pranayama. Prana is the Sanskrit word for energy. Yama is the way that we say the control of energy, the way that we can move energy, we can guide energy. So let's sit on our heels, so your hips are resting on your heels. Hands on your thighs, relax your shoulders. This one is called Samavritti. Sama, like exactly the same, like same, sama, same. Vritti means waves or fluctuations. So that which changes is also the same. There's a quality. The way that this exercise works is for an inhale for 4 seconds, we fill up, and then exhale for 4 seconds. Both are in and out through the nose. Then we go to 6 seconds and exhale for 6 seconds. 8 seconds and exhale for 8. We move all the way up to 12, and then from 12 we make our way all the way back down to 4. And then we'll sit in a short meditation, just close our eyes. We've already been there today, so it's not new to you guys. And then we'll close in Shavasana. I'll talk you through it. Hands on your thighs. Sit tall. If this hurts for any reason, find a seat that works for you. You can, like I said at the beginning, towel behind your knees or sitting on a block. Beginning. First exhale so your lungs are empty. And then inhale for 4, 3, 2, 1. Pause. Exhale out your nose. 4, 3, 2, 1. And pause. Let's go for 6. Inhale for 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pause. Exhale for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Pause through your nose. Inhale for 8, 7 to full. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Pause and exhale for 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold and release slowly. 10, 9, 8, take your time. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhaling for 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pause and exhale for 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Making our way down to 10. Inhale for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold. Exhale. 10, 9, 8. Let it out. Really slowly. 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale for 6, 5. Fill up fully. 3, 2, 1. Exhale for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Pause. Inhale for 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale for 4, 3, 2, 1. Return to your normal breathing. Return to your normal breath, just in and out the nose. If there's a more comfortable seat, you can find that right now. That was really beautiful, guys. Really well done. From here, just cross your legs, please. Sit back on your hips. And we're gonna lower into Shavasana. Shavasana is the final pose, and it is a pose. So the cultivation of this pose will actually deepen your practice. And I know that it's like, what am I doing? I'm just lying on my back. But it's an active practice of relaxation. Arms by your sides, legs at least mat width apart, hips nice and heavy, jaw nice and soft. Close your eyes. Allow for your hips to be the anchor. Allow for your belly to be soft. Jaw softens. Eyes soften. The tip of your tongue softens all the way to the root of your tongue. You're not even breathing anymore. You're observing the breath that's both filling you up and pouring out. You almost become so effortless that you're just the observer of the subtle sensations that your body's experiencing. I want to thank you. What a beautiful, beautiful time that we spent together. Thank you for your attention and for staying from beginning to end. I want to wish you a beautiful day. Feel free to stay in Shavasana for as long as you please. As we say, the light inside me bows and acknowledges the light inside you. Namaste. See you soon. Окей, тебе нужно быть где-то, где я могу говорить с тобой. И не напрягите меня, не смотреть на мои пальцы ног и как-то на мое лицо. Окей, ты готова?